a block of steel, specific gravity is equal to 7.85, floats at a mercury water interface as shown in figure. What is the ratio of A and B for this condition? Given that specific gravity of mercury is 13.57. Now the figure is given like this. This is water. This is steel block. Up to here there is mercury. This is all mercury. The dotted spots, they're all mercury. This is water. This is steel block. This gap is B and this gap is A. What is the ratio between A and B? The solution to this problem could be given as, let the block have a uniform cross-sectional area A. Under the condition of floating equilibrium, as shown in figure, weight of body is equal to total buoyancy force acting on it. A into A plus B, that is the cross-sectional area as from the frontal view. A is the area perpendicular, capital A is the area of the block perpendicular to the plane of the figure. A plus B is the depth of block. So capital A into A plus B shall give the volume of the block into 7850 specific gravity. Volume into density will give the mass. Mass into g is the weight, is equal to b into 13.57 plus a, this into a into g into 10 cube. That is the weight of the right, what is the right hand side, weight of the mercury displaced plus weight of the water displaced, that should be equal to the volume of the block submerged in mercury into specific weight of mercury plus volume of the block submerged in water into specific weight of water. That is the right hand side, or the total buoyancy force. As from Archimedes' principle, buoyancy force acting on a body is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced by the body. Right hand side of this equation indicates what is the weight of the mercury displaced plus what is the weight of the water displaced by the steel block. Implies 7.85 into A plus B is equal to 13.57 into B plus A, implies A by B is equal to, this is equal to 0.835. Hence the problem. Next problem on buoyancy. An aluminium cube ...150 mm on a side is suspended by a string in oil and water as shown in figure. The cube is submerged with half of it being in oil and the other half in water. Find the tension in the string if the specific gravity of oil is 0.8 and the specific weight of aluminium is 25.93 kilonewton per meter cube. The figure of the problem is given like this. This is oil, 75 mm of depth of oil. This is all oil. This is oil. This is all water. This is a cube. This is 150 mm. So the solution to this problem could be given like this. Tension T in the string can be written in consideration of the equilibrium of the cube as there are three forces acting on the cube: tension upwards, force of buoyancy upwards, and weight of the cube downwards. Therefore, tension should be equal to the weight minus FB. What is the weight? 25.93 specific weight into 10 cube, that is in newtons, into 0.15 whole cube, that is the volume of the cube, minus what is the force of buoyancy? Weight of the oil displaced plus weight of the water displaced. Therefore, force of buoyancy can be written as 9.81 into 10 cube, 0.15 cube into 0.5 into 0.8. Plus 0.15 cube into 0.5 into 1. please note that force of buoyancy is the weight of the oil displaced plus weight of the water displaced. The tension will be 57.71 newtons. Now there is a small correction in the problem, in the solution. If you write the force of buoyancy, tension is upwards, of course. What is the weight of the oil displaced? Volume of the this part of the cube. How much that will be? 0.75 into 0.15 whole square plus 0.15 whole square into 150 minus 75 will become 0.75. So 0.15 whole square into 0.75 into 1, that is the volume of the water displaced. And as compared to the, coming to the top half of the top, not half exactly, but the top portion of the cube in contact with oil, it is 0.15 whole square into 0.75 into 0.8. Of course, it's not 0.75, it is 0.075. I shall write again the force of buoyancy here to avoid the confusion. 0.075 into 0.15 whole square, that is the volume of the oil displaced, into specific weight of oil is 0.8 into 9.81 into 10 cube plus what is the weight of the water displaced, volume of the water displaced, that is 150 minus 0.075 is 0.075 into 0.15 whole square. What is the specific weight of water? Into 9.81 into 10 cube. This is the force of buoyancy. Please substitute above accordingly and then get the tension T. I shall solve a problem given in a gate 2003. A cylindrical body of cross sectional area A, height h and density rho s is immersed to a depth h in a liquid of density rho and tied to the bottom with a string. The tension in the string is, the figure is given like this. This is the cylinder tied to the bottom with a string. Up to here liquid. Total height of the cylinder is H. This is the cross sectional area of the cylinder. This is string. The answers were given as rho g ha, rho s minus rho into g ha, rho minus rho s into g ha, rho h minus rho s h into g a. Now the solution to this problem could be given like this. The forces acting on the cylinder are its weight, tension T, and force of buoyancy. Weight is equal to A into H, that is the volume of the cylinder, into density of the solid cylinder rho s into g. What is the force of buoyancy? Weight of liquid displaced, that is equal to volume of liquid displaced into rho of the liquid into g. What is the volume of the liquid displaced? How much portion of the cylinder is in contact with the liquid? Only h depth. Therefore, A into small h, that is the volume of the cylinder submerged, or the volume of the liquid displaced. Whatever the volume of the cylinder is submerged, same volume of the liquid will be displaced, into rho, that is the density of the liquid, into g. Substituting in the above equilibrium equation, force of buoyancy plus force of buoyancy is equal to weight plus tension. Therefore, tension is equal to force of buoyancy minus weight of cylinder A H rho G minus A H rho S G. So, what is the answer there? Rho minus rho S into rho H minus rho S H into GA. Answer is D. Hence the problem. I shall solve another problem regarding buoyancy. An empty balloon and its equipment weighs 441.45 newtons. When inflated with the gas weighing 5.415 newton per meter cube, the balloon is spherical and 7 meters in diameter. What is the maximum weight of cargo that the balloon can lift, assuming air to weigh 12.066 Newton per meter cube. The solution to this problem could be best given if you can represent the problem pictorially. It is a spherical balloon. After inflating, the diameter is 3.5 meter after inflating with the gas. This is gas, this is tension. This is the cargo or the weight that could be lifted up. So how many forces are acting on the balloon? If we draw the free body diagram, weight of the gas downwards, force of buoyancy upwards, and weight of cargo. There are three forces, two downward forces, that is the weight of the gas and weight of cargo. Upward force is a force of buoyancy. What is the force of buoyancy? Weight of air displaced. The problem could be solved like this. The force of buoyancy, the weight of air displaced, is equal to volume of air displaced into specific weight of air. What is the volume of air displaced? Since the bulb is floating in air, the balloon is floating in air, the volume of the balloon itself into specific weight of air. What is the volume of the balloon? 4/3 pi r cube into specific weight of air. That is 4/3 into pi into what is the radius of the balloon? 3.5 meters into what is the specific weight of air? 12.066. So many newtons. Then what is the weight of gas? Is equal to volume of balloon into specific weight of gas. What is the volume of the balloon? 4/3 into pi r cube into what is the specific weight of gas? That is given as 5.415. 4/3 in 3 into 3.5 whole cube into 5.415. so many newtons. Therefore, force of buoyancy is equal to weight of cargo, that is nothing but the tension in the string or rope, plus weight of gas, implies weight of cargo is equal to force of buoyancy minus weight of gas. That will be 753.03 newtons. That is the answer. That is the weight of the cargo. Roughly 75 kg or 76 kg of the weight could be lifted by the balloon after inflating with the gas. Hence the problem. Now I shall do another problem on buoyancy. The problem is given like this. An iceberg weighing 8976 Newton per meter cube, that is the specific weight of the iceberg, floats in the ocean with a volume of 600 meter cube above the surface. Determine the total volume of the iceberg. If specific weight of ocean water is 10,055 Newton per meter cube. The solution to this problem could be given like this. Representing the problem pictorial manner, this may be the iceberg. With a volume of 600 meter cube above the surface, this is the surface. Let V be the total volume of iceberg in a meter cube, implies V minus X is the V minus 600 is equal to volume of iceberg submerged in sea water. How many forces are acting on the iceberg? Only two forces. For equilibrium of iceberg, weight of iceberg is equal to force of buoyancy. What is the weight of iceberg? B into specific weight of iceberg is equal to what is the force of buoyancy? Weight of sea water displaced. That what is the weight of sea water displaced? Volume of sea water displaced into specific weight of sea water. What is the volume of the sea water displaced? Volume of the iceberg submerged, that is V minus 600, that is the volume of the iceberg submerged into specific weight of sea water is given as 10055 V into, what is the specific weight of iceberg? 8976. From this, volume of the iceberg is obtained as 5591 meter cube. Hence the problem. The normal stress is the same in all the directions at a point in a fluid. The objective question is given like this. The normal stress at a point is the same in all the directions at a point in a fluid. A. Only when the fluid is frictionless. B. Only when the fluid is frictionless and incompressible. C. In a liquid at rest. And D. When the fluid is at rest regardless of its nature. In fact, this law is stated as the Pascal's law of hydrostatics. This is valid whenever a fluid is at rest. In fact, for a fluid at rest, there are no tangential stresses or shear stresses or viscous stresses acting on it. The viscous stresses comes into picture only when the fluid is in motion. The only stresses